What got Justin and his friends kicked out of a hotel room?
Millennial child Eric was vaping into the smoke detector.
Find out which news story inspired this look.
Oh my God, Mike found a scarf and a fedora.
Watch how we play cornhole.
Oh, the hole is right over there. Right. Oh man, it's... How's that treating? Is it right where it needs to be?
Plus, Coach John Harbaugh and 98 Rock surprise a Ravens fan.
Coach John Harbaugh's
all that and comedian Josh Wolf coming up next with one of the weirdest videos ever.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel?
The 98 Rock Morning Show?
Yep, I'm an idiot. What is happening right now?
Pay me to talk!
What are they doing on my TV?
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV.
This past weekend, I won the cornhole tournament at my pool. Practice makes perfect, and I've had a lot of practice. I've even had some practice right here in the studio. Check out this clip as we play one of our favorite games, Corn Nuts.
Justin is now taking his shoes off.
Oh, good thing I didn't get to go under the board because I don't wear underwear. You're taking your pants off. I wouldn't have been able to do that. He's taking his pants off. We're getting. Yeah, there's not a lot of padding there now.
I'm moving over, so there's no.
I feel like denim might have
provided too much. Too much comfort.
Oh, the hole is right over
right.
Your crotch.
Oh, man, it's... How's that treating? Is it right where it needs to be?
All right, here we go.
All right.
Toss number one.
Oh, God, here it comes.
Oh! Oh yeah!
Bullseye!
Yeah! Oh, shot one, baby! What's up, Bob?
Oh!
Justin is writhing in. Justin's writhing in pain.
Oh, this is so stupid.
He's in the fetal position now.
Oh, God, you went right in. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not prepared.
Okay, second and third shot. Scott missed. Fourth shot.
I'm just for fun. We already
won.
We already won.
The first one right in.
Come on, baby.
How did you get the first one right in my balls? Oh, my God. That hurts so much. I feel like I want to throw up.
So that last segment focused a little bit on Scott and I, but not enough on Josh. So to balance it all out, here's a nice montage of Spiegel losing his mind.
God! Well, he didn't specifically say that! What is going on? You got me all fired up now, you jackass.
Right here, drafting!
Hey, Scott, Rick! Another great idea from Rick!
You're 5'10".
How does that happen?
I said set flowers! You're supposed to freeze your credit, Paul! You're supposed to freeze your credit! 7,000 times yesterday!
I don't know if it's true.
I don't know if it's
true. You know
true
what they did?
It makes no sense. Is the world upside down? I don't want to go up on stage, okay? I'm off duty right now. I hate Paul, that son of a bitch.
Why? What did Paul
I want to kill him. I want to kill. I don't know. He just had an attitude. Give all the land to Amazon. Damn it!
Jesus, what is happening?
Oh!
Up next.
What are you doing, Eric?
Just holding this alarm so it can stop. There's people outside. Sorry.
It's all fun and games until you get booted from a hotel room. Justin and his friends went on a road trip recently. See why they got kicked out.
I'm on drink number two. I'm feeling no pain. And then... What the hell is that sound?
That sound you're playing, that sounds like your favorite song compared to what we were actually listening to, which was a high-pitched...
Eric, oh my God.
That sound I just played was Zeppelin.
Hey, Josh.
Compared to what happened.
How long did this fire alarm, which was just a high-pitched note, how long did that play before we left the hotel room? How long? How long did we hear that?
You're asking me what I think?
How long do you think that played before we were finally like, you know what? Time to go.
I'm going to say 15 minutes.
An hour.
One hour.
Well, here's what happened. Friend, comedian Eric Woodworth, he is a millennial and child, and so he's vaping.
Nonstop.
But he's also, he's not just vaping.
He's ripping cumulus clouds in the room. Giant Hiroshima-like clouds,
and he is directly under the smoke detector.
What are you doing, Eric?
Just holding this alarm so it can stop. There's people outside. Sorry.
Joe, watch out.
I on my family's name.
That is the fire department lights.
He stood there for 20 minutes with pillows over the vent trying to dull the sound of this thing.
Well, there was turns. Yeah. Justin also took a turn. Holding the pillows on top of there. Now, here's the thing. I was worried, right? I was worried more of a charge or getting kicked out, right? I didn't want to have to leave.
I don't want to be sent off
into
the night.
That was my initial fear. My initial fear was that until we looked out the window and here comes a fire truck.
Ah.
Down the road.
Here it comes.
Fire truck is pulling into the parking lot. Josh, do you know what else came?
A SWAT team?
A second fire truck.
A second fire truck was there. Two fire trucks, middle of the night. We're all drunk. He's been vaping directly into the fire alarm. We're all freaked out. We've called downstairs letting them know, hey, it's our room. Now, Justin thought he pulled himself a clutch move. You know what I did? You know what I did to try and keep them from getting us in trouble? Because my dear friend, and as Joe pointed out, millennial child Eric, was vaping into the smoke detector. I said, hey, someone get me a lighter real quick. Do you know what I did with that lighter? I set my arm hair on fire.
Oh my God. I burned
my arm hair to say, hey, I was doing a silly and I burnt my arm hair. That's what must have tricked the thing into going off. Yes, I burnt my arm. That was that level of drunk clutch to where at the time I thought it was a great idea to set my arm on fire.
By the way, do you know what the firefighters said when they came to the room?
No.
They said nothing. They never came to the room.
They didn't care. Yes, not once.
Oh, all it smelled like was vape juice and arm hair in there.
It smelled so bad. We called downstairs and begged them, can you turn this thing off? Because we're looking down the hallway for them to show up. Heads are popping out of other hotel rooms. What the hell is that? Why is that going off? We call down there. We're working on it. We call down there 20 minutes later. We're working on it. Then they say the fire department has to be the ones to turn it off. They can't figure it out. They have to call the general manager who lives like 40 minutes away.
Next thing you know, we look out the window and Justin, all the firefighters, I guess, are in the hotel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're all there.
But Justin is out by the fire truck and his pants are down.
Yeah, there you go. I had my pants off.
So here's a picture of Justin.
Yeah, I thought, you know what'll help this? You know what Tito's said would be a great idea? If I just started doing laps around the fire truck and just my boxer shorts. Didn't help anything.
You're so free. I wish I was so uninhibited.
Boy, yeah, a bit of a showman there.
Stay tuned.
Weird. I go into weird.
Okay, you want me to read the title of the video?
Kind of weird.
So, guy in bunny suit gets lit on fire.
That's what happened.
Here on the Justin Scott and Spiegel Morning Show, we are pretty lucky to be able to hang out with some of the best comedians in the country right here in studio. Comedian Josh Wolf stopped in, was amazing. Check it out now as hilarity ensued.
The last couple Mondays, I've taken mushrooms and then smoked weed, and then I turn on the camera for an hour. And I will tell you something, it's my favorite hour of the week for a couple reasons. One, it's just me getting to do whatever I want. I don't have to be funny if I don't want to. There's no pressure. I just sit
there.
Wait,
so this is not a comedy show? It's like a vlog.
Sometimes it's funny because I'm high on mushrooms.
Do these still exist or they go up and go down?
No, they live on my YouTube page, all the old ones. And the new one happens every Monday night on 7 o'clock.
Subscribing.
You should come. You should watch, man.
Hell yeah.
I last week and every now and then I have like 30 pairs of sunglasses that I keep around and I put them on and every now and then when I take the mushrooms a different character comes out.
Oh Jesus!
And this week a guy who called himself the Cookie Man came out and the Cookie Man wore a cowboy hat and those googly eye glasses. And man, he gets mad if you touch his cookies.
Oh Jesus! There he is. He's got his Bonos on.
Oh check yeah!
Hold on, wait a second. Look at that. Oh, do you have him? Yes!
You know, Josh,
I mean, those come on, out. Man.
You look like my drunk aunt.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Those glasses are awesome. I won't wear sunglasses now if you don't think your Nana would wear them. if your Nana wouldn't wear these sunglasses, I'm not putting them on my face.
That's hilarious.
The High Life. Look, man, I got to show you Cookie Man. Oh, and you guys don't know, I only smoke out of a baby hand.
What?
What?
So I have.
Does that mean?
All right, I will have. Did I show you the photo?
You just had one up.
Yeah, I have.
What is? Oh, this is, I don't know if I'm like.
I only smoke out of my baby hand. I'm so envious.
I think I'm very envious.
So this is the baby hand, right? And I put it on top of my finger, and I only smoke out of the baby hand. And so the baby hand fits on my finger, and it's like a little. It's,
oh wow!
It's a cigarette holder. And so I only smoke out of my baby hand.
Josh,
and he's called smoking baby hand.
I need your recipe. Whatever you take, I want to start taking.
I'm showing you,
I'm
Scott,
you guys.
A still shot of one of his videos. Explain what the hell is happening.
Okay. Is that your backyard?
So what's happening in there in that video? Weird things make me really happy. Like more than deep dives into porn. Weird. I go into weird.
Okay, I'm going to read the title
of
the video.
Weird.
So
guy in bunny suit gets lit on fire.
That's what happened. So I was in Utah and I was traveling with a buddy of mine named Steven Randolph. And Steven was like, hey man, there's a guy here who I know that does weird stunts. He says that he'll put himself in a bunny outfit and light himself on fire.
Sign me up.
And then jump off of a ladder.
Yes.
And onto a 2x4 onto his nuts and break
it.
And he was like, do you want to see that? And I said, yeah.
Yeah?
I love that stuff.
Oh, my God.
So he lit himself on fire. He climbed up a ladder. He jumped off of it. He nutted himself. Bam! And then he crawled into a tub of water. It was amazing!
Yes! Yes!
I love that.
And then your buddy comes over and sets the pool on fire.
I know!
He's trying to set the pool on fire. He's trying to put himself out in.
Coming up next.
He's going to be the first ever to read an NFL draft card off of Braille. You know Mo, an amazing guy. Thanks, Mo, for doing this, but I can't wait to get on the phone with this guy. It's going to be so much fun.
Rock is the flagship of the Baltimore Ravens, and one of the special things about working with the team is how we get to interact with fans in very special ways.
Earlier this spring, we were able to spend some time with local sports fan Mo Gabba, three-time cancer survivor who went blind at the age of 9 months.
Mo joined the show from his school where he got a special offer from Ravens coach John Harbaugh. Take a look.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Coach John Harbaugh to the program.
Hi.
Coach Harbaugh! The flagship station
Say
of the Baltimore Ravens.
Hi.
Yeah, it's great to be with you guys. Hey, Mo, how you doing, buddy?
Good.
How's everything going over there at school? You guys at Lindale getting after it today? Attacking this day with enthusiasm?
It's always busy around here.
Oh, I'll bet it is. I'll bet it is. Working hard to get better, right? We heard about this guy that calls into talk radio on 98 Rock and has incredible insights into the Ravens and what we do and how good we're going to be. And we heard he's one of our very, very biggest fans. And we have an announcement to make. We're inviting Mo to announce our fourth-round draft pick at our Draft Fest event at the Inner Harbor to be the guy that announces the event.
Yeah. What? Really?
We're going to announce the fourth-round pick at the Draft Fest to the world at Ravens Draft Fest. What do you think?
I like to do that. Yeah.
Yes, right. There you go. Mo Gabba. You're going to be announcing that draft pick alongside the Baltimore Ravens. You know what? There's no better person to announce a Baltimore Ravens draft pick than a diehard Baltimore Ravens fan, local broadcast legend, sports legend like Mo Gabba. Mo, is this going to be the beginning of your sports broadcasting career right here this week?
It's going to start. It's going to start this week.
All right. Hey, Coach, thank you. Mo, thank you, buddy.
Coach, thank you so much. Coach Harbaugh of the Baltimore Ravens on the flagship station of the Baltimore Ravens joining us. Coach Harbaugh, it's been a pleasure. Thank you for taking the time, sir.
Thanks, guys. Love you guys. Thanks a lot.
There he goes, Coach Harbaugh. And we still got Mo Gabb on the phone. Mo, talk to me about all the things you've been through, buddy. You have overcome so much on your fourth battle with cancer, another battle I know you'll win like the prior three. Blind since the age of one doesn't even slow you down a bit. Tell other people, other kids out there that might be listening, that if they're a little down because of what they might be going through, what you do to make it through and make it past in spite of all you've had to deal with, what keeps you so positive and so successful?
Well, just thinking positive is all you can do, really. All you gotta do is just think positive, and you'll get through it. Nothing can slow you down unless you, if you think positive.
Now you got me tearing up over here, Mo.
It's dusty in here now.
Mo, you got my eyes watering here. We love you, buddy.
This kid has overcome.
Oh man, question.
It's kicking my ass a little bit right now. Sorry, Mo. Adults got sometimes when they get emotional. I love you. You're the best. I can't wait to hear you announce that fourth historical draft pick off of a Braille card. Mo, it's been our pleasure talking to you. You call us, you stop up anytime. This show is your show.
Don't you have to get back to class, Mo?
Yeah. Yeah.
Take care, Mo.
See ya.
Mo, take it away.
With the 123rd pick in the 2019 NFL Draft, the Baltimore Ravens select Benton Powers, Oklahoma guard.
Coming up next.
Dude, just one button changes the whole
vibe. It was two buttons.
Mike.
But it changes the whole vibe.
My Adam's apple hurts.
You know, we're always on the cutting edge of fashion, like me wearing these fashionable bracelets. It's a thing. But on this particular morning, we went all in hipster style.
Researchers from MIT did a study on the hipster effect about how hipsters tend to gravitate towards similar fashion trends and all look the same. Then after they posted it, someone complained about a stock photo they used of a hipster with a beard wearing a knit hat. The guy who complained says he was the model in the photo and he was upset at them for implying he's a generic hipster. But it turns out it was actually a different model in the photo who just looks like him. The guy was angry at them for implying he's a generic hipster who looks like every other hipster. And it turns out he's such a generic hipster, he couldn't even tell himself apart from a random guy with a beard. Researchers joked that it essentially proves the whole point of the study that hipsters do look alike.
That's hilarious.
He completely just got himself. You played yourself, kid. Yeah, again, if you need to find one in the wild, just
head to Hampton.
Head to Hampton.
Or Remington.
Oh, yeah.
Spiegs is wearing a bit of a hipsterish shirt today.
Yes, I am.
Are you able to button the top button on that?
Yeah, I can. But
I mean, all the way up. You got to go all the way up.
No,
can't hit the neck on that bad boy.
It would be tight.
Because that would make you.
And here comes Mike with the camera.
Go full on hipster mode.
Go full hipster.
You got to button it all the way up.
There you go.
We got a wool hat for him anywhere?
Do we have a typewriter he could carry into a coffee house? Can we do that?
Mike's going to go
run and see if we have thin suspenders? Just one button changes the whole
vibe. It was two buttons.
Mike.
But it changes the whole vibe.
My Adam's apple hurts.
It's
a little tight.
It's squeezing in on you.
Most hipsters are a tad underweight.
Wow. We've got a fedora. Oh, my God. Mike found a scarf
and a fedora. Why do we
take
have
your
these
headphones
things?
Off? Take your headphones off. Rip that feather off of the fedora.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's got to go.
Oh! Look at hipster Josh. glasses back on. Glasses, if you could, please.
Yeah, glasses.
Glasses,
to be
please.
On.
Ladies and gentlemen, hipster Josh.
It's that easy, folks.
Oh, my God.
Here's one final news story before we wrap it up.
Sorry, Spiegel. We're using this last minute for a blooper reel.
Here I am in the very cubicle. Never before seen.
Testing. Yep, looks good to me.
Who's reading this line? We don't know.
See what happened to Justin. Well, Justin and his friends went on a recent...
Damn it. Won my pool's car.
Hang out with the two. Goddamn it.
Oh, I just stepped on the cable. Oh, it hurts so much. Okay, all right, let me know when we're good.
Is that police officers need to be.
Unfortunately, we hear plenty of news about children cooking to death in cars. Is that right?
Do your dance, do your dance.
Yes! Yes!
Get down on all fours. No, wait till it hits the ground. Boom! Oh. There we go. That's great.
Classic.
Yeah, that's OG internet right there.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Just go ahead. All that?
1, 2, 3, 4. That's a really sweet blazer you're wearing. You look like a professor.
Sucked down into the earth.
Damn it!
A clip where we tried on some more accessories to see what else would work.
All right, go ahead.
Hold on, the person.
His legs.
What the hell? What the F?
I was looking away.
That's fine.
3, 2. Well, wait a second.
All that and another edition.
Sorry.
Coming up 3.
Oh, the outtakes reel is getting
real quick. Okay. 3.